The invention of polyurethane skateboard wheels in the early 1970s suddenly made jumps and tight cornering possible, because these wheels had a better grip than the old metal or ceramic versions. These new wheels were more durable, and the shock absorption was greatly improved. Roll on. Skateboard wheels come in different sizes, hardness, colors, and graphic designs. There are many practical and aesthetic considerations, all depending on the skater's style and preference. To make skateboard wheels, the first step is to design and create the mold. The computer software guides the machine's cutting tools, shaping a solid aluminium park into one half of the wheel mold. Next, the other half of the mold is created, as the computerized tooling sculpts another puck that will marry with the first to create the final complete mold. Not all of the wheel molds consist of two parts. These are made from one piece of aluminium and have a pin in the center to form a bearing cavity. Then dispensed into the wheel molds is liquid polyurethane, which begins to solidify. To complete the curing process, the polyurethane-filled molds are loaded into an oven and are baked at 115 degrees Celsius for 40 minutes. The baking process also ensures that any bubbles in the polyurethane rise and are diffused, leaving a solid mass with no weak spots. The pins are removed from the molds, and it's then on to the next station. Here, a blast of compressed air around the wheels pops them out of the molds. As seen here, the wheels have a high rebound, an indication that the skateboard wheel will roll easily with very little drag. To ensure the polyurethane has cured to the correct hardness, a durometer gauge is used to test the sample wheel. If the sample is sufficiently hard, the batch is ready for the next step. Each wheel is then placed into a lathe, where it's spun while a cutting tool contours the edge to a smoother, more rounded profile. To give the skateboard wheels a visual impact, a graphic design is added to each one. First, a film negative is printed of the chosen images. This negative is used to produce a printing plate. Inside a UV light chamber, the film negative is placed on top of a piece of metal that's been coated with a light-sensitive emulsion. Closing the lid and activating the UV light triggers a photochemical reaction that transfers the image from the negative to the plate. Here you can see the image now very faintly on the printing plate. Next, a solution is applied that removes the unexposed emulsion, and in the process, etches the image into the metal plate. The chemicals are then rinsed off. Drying the plate reveals the etched-in artwork. A magnetized ink dispenser is then placed over the image, and both are then installed into a pad printing machine. Individual skateboard wheels are placed onto posts, which then travel into the printing machine. The ink dispenser deposits ink on the printing plate. Then a silicon pad picks up the inked image and stamps it onto the skateboard wheel. A sample wheel is then clamped into a testing device, which will establish the rebound. A metal ball is dropped on the wheel, and how high it bounces or rebounds is measured. Again, the higher, the better. These skateboard wheels have been cleared for shipping, so they're sent to be packed. It's taken about 3 days to make these skateboard wheels. Now, I just need to replace the ones I broke on my last ride. Then, I'll be ready to roll. Once me broken leg is healed, that is. Honeycomb candles are glowing reminders of the cleverness of the honeybee. These candles are embossed with a hexagonal pattern that mimics the cell structures bees build to store their honey. And these candles are actually made from the wax foundation sheets that are used for beehive frames. The process begins using beeswax that's had the impurities removed and has been bleached. The wax is melted in a large gas-heated vat. The bleached wax will need to be coloured, and it only takes a few grams of dye to tint the large vat of wax. The dye is added, and the liquid is stirred to distribute it evenly. Next, a valve is opened, and the wax flows into a trough that's beneath a large drum. The drum is cooled by a system of chillers. As it rotates, it picks up the wax, which solidifies on contact with the drum's cooled surface. The wax is then pulled through a small opening to create an even thickness. At this point, the consistency of the wax is similar to that of toffee, but unlike toffee, it's not very sticky, so the layers don't stick together when collected in a roll. Next, a bath of warm water and soap is prepared. The roll of beeswax is then loosened to slacken and separate the layers, leaving space between them. The sheet is immersed in the bath to soften the wax in preparation of being rolled to reduce the thickness even further, by half. Using blocks of ice, the softened wax is then cooled to firm it up again. Liquid soap is constantly added for lubrication. This keeps the beeswax moving through the thinning machine and prevents snags. A caliper is used to confirm that the sheet is the required thickness of 1.6 millimeters. The roll of beeswax is then transferred from the thinning machine to the embossing machine for the next stage. The sheet is first pulled through a bath of icy water to harden it further. This stops the wax from sticking to the embossing rollers that will now imprint a hexagonal pattern into it. Each of the embossing rollers is studded with 3,500 hexagon-shaped rivets, which stamp the pattern into both sides of the wax. A blade slices the embossed beeswax into sheets, which now pass under a roller, which propels them into a neat stack. A sample sheet is examined to ensure the honeycomb texture has no bubbles or other flaws. At this state, the sheet can be used as starter material in beehives. To make them into candles, the sheets are cut to the required length and width. The dimensions will vary depending on the size of the candles to be made. The offcuts will be melted down and reused. These beeswax sheets are now ready to be made into candles. First, a cotton wick is positioned on one edge of the sheet. The wax is then wrapped around the wick. Gentle pressure is applied as the sheet is rolled, because the tighter the roll, the longer the candle will take to burn. Being made at room temperature means that the wax is warm, so the layers adhere together. These honeycomb beeswax candles are now ready to throw some light wherever you light them.